One of the things that we need to discuss in order to get a firm handle on genetics throughout the semester is how to draw representations of chromosomes. We're often used to seeing chromosomes as X-shaped objects in images, photographs, and in drawings in the textbook and on web pages. And I want you to realize that what this really is each of these lines is two separate molecules of DNA that are meeting at the centromere, C-E-N. And so when you overlap those two, you get something that's an X-shaped, looks like one X-shaped object. It's actually two molecules of DNA. And each of these molecules of DNA, if we blew it up and looked at it in a magnified view, would actually be a double helix with two individual strands of DNA. Here's one strand, there's another strand, and that is two strands of DNA with base pairs comprising hydrogen bonds in between. Now, this is a lot of detail for me to draw normally during active classroom sessions. And so I'll often refer to chromosomes as using these single lines. So I'll often represent one chromosome as a line. When you see this, you should realize that what I'm actually drawing is representing is this double helix. So two strands of DNA, and that is a representation of a chromosome. A chromosome is one piece of double-stranded DNA. Each of these base pairs is represented by a nucleotide. There are three nucleotides in DNA, four chemicals, A's, G's, C's, and T's, that stand for adenine, guanine, cytosine, and thymine. And when we write out the letter sequence of a DNA molecule such as this, we often use single letter abbreviations, T's, A's, G's, and C's. So I could, for example, write this as the sequence of nucleotides, a random sequence of nucleotides, on one molecule of DNA, one chromosome. But this is only the sequence of one of these strands of the double helix. This is a convention that's important for you to understand, that we only write out one of the strand sequences, and this is often in the polarity starting at the 5' end and ending at the 3' end. The reason that we only have to write one of the DNA sequences from one strand is that the other strand is given to us by base pair complementation. You probably already know that every thymine base pairs using two hydrogen bonds with adenine, and every guanine base pairs using three hydrogen bonds with cytosine. So given one strand of DNA sequence information, then you can deduce by complementation what the sequence of the opposite strand of DNA is. So I'm going to ask you now to do one little exercise for me that we'll talk about in class, and tell me what the complementary sequence is to this chromosome sequence. So bring the answer to this with you to the next class. What would be the sequence of the other strand that would comprise the double helix for this DNA molecule?